President Trump is celebrating McCabe's firing just 2 days before McCabe's scheduled retirement, calling it a good day for democracy. According to a source briefed on the matter, McCabe has already been interviewed by the special counsel's team about the firing of James Comey. McCabe also handed over memos detailing his own conversations with President Trump and what Comey told him about his interactions with the president. In fact, just minutes ago, President Trump pushed back on that, tweeting, quote, "Spent very little time with Andrew McCabe, but he never took notes when he was with me. I don't believe he made memos except to help his own agenda, probably at a later date. Same with lying James Comey. Can we call them fake memos?" Unquote. Joining us now to talk about this and much more is Republican Senator Jeff Flake of Arizona. He's a member of the Judiciary Committee. Senator, thanks for joining us. The president also just tweeted this, quote, "Why does the Mueller team have 13 hardened Democrats, some big crooked Hillary supporters, and zero Republicans? Another Dem recently added, does anyone think this is fair? And yet there is no collusion." Obviously, the description he has of the Mueller team is much disputed. As he doesn't mention, for instance, that Mueller is a Republican. But beyond that, do you think that the president is laying the groundwork to fire Mueller?
Well, when the president said it was a great day for democracy yesterday, I think it was a horrible day for democracy. To have firings like this happening at the top from the president and the attorney general does not speak well for what's going on. So I don't know what the designs are on Mueller, but it seems to be building toward that. And I just hope it doesn't go there, because it can't. I mean, we can't in Congress accept that. And so I would expect to see considerable pushback in the next couple of days and urging the president not to go there. He can't go there.
So just to ask about the McCabe firing, Attorney General Sessions has said that the recommendation came from the Office of Inspector General and internally, and it wasn't, he suggested it wasn't because of anything President Trump said. But of course, there is this very politicized context. President Trump has been calling for McCabe's firing for more than a year. After the firing, you tweeted, as you noted, it was a great day for democracy. McCabe said in a statement his firing was driven by the president, writing, quote, "The Office of Inspector General's focus on me and this report became part of an unprecedented effort by the administration, driven by the president himself, to remove me from my position, destroy my reputation, and possibly strip me of a pension that I worked 21 years to earn." So you are not buying the Sessions explanation. You believe that he was fired because President Trump put pressure on the Justice Department to do so.
Well, I'm certainly, like everyone else, waiting for the IG report to come out, and so I don't want to go too far ahead. But I can tell you it will come out, and we in Congress have oversight in that regard. The Senate Judiciary Committee will be looking into it. So I'm just very surprised that the president would get so far ahead of this and make the statements that he's made, because we will know. And I'm just puzzled by why the White House is going so hard at this, other than they're very afraid of what might come out. I don't know how you can have any other conclusion.
The president's lawyer, John Dowd, said in response to McCabe's firing that the Justice Department should, quote, follow the brilliant and courageous example of the FBI Office of Professional Responsibility and Attorney General Jeff Sessions and bring an end to the alleged Russia collusion investigation manufactured by McCabe's boss, James Comey, unquote. Again, there are a lot of factual misstatements in there. But let me ask you, you've already said, based on President Trump suggesting the Mueller probe should end, that you expect to see pushback. I don't know why you expect to see pushback, to be honest. I've been watching Congress now for the last year, and with the exception of you and maybe Ben Sasse and John McCain, I haven't seen a lot of pushback from Republicans. Do you really think that Mitch McConnell and Paul Ryan will stand up and say, no, Mr. President, you can't do this?
I hope so. I mean, talking to my colleagues all along, it was, once he goes after Mueller, then we'll take action. I think that people see that as a massive red line that can't be crossed. So I hope that that's the case. And I would just hope that enough people would prevail on the president now. Don't go there. Don't go there. We have confidence in Mueller. I certainly do. And I think my colleagues do as well. So I hope that the pushback is now to keep the president from going there.
Let's turn now to something else that Mueller's looking into, which was covered in a bombshell report in the New York Times and another one in the Guardian newspaper. The conservative data firm Cambridge Analytica, which worked with the Trump campaign in 2016, Facebook is now accusing the company of fraudulently obtaining data from more than 50 million Americans and then lying about it. We know Mueller's looking into Cambridge Analytica as part of this Russia investigation. What questions might you have about this issue, especially when it comes to Russian interference in the election?
Right. Well, certainly, who knew what when? This is a big deal when you have that amount of data, and the privacy violations there are significant. So the question is, who knew it? When did they know it? How long did this go on? And what happens to that data now? I guess there's some discrepancy as to whether or not it's been expunged or given back, or if it's still held and being used. So that was a big report, significant reporting.
You've also said that you're actively considering whether or not you're going to challenge President Trump in 2020. You've said you haven't made a decision. It's not likely, but it is on the table.
Right.
You just gave a speech at the famous Politics and Eggs breakfast in New Hampshire, which is obviously the first in the nation primary state. I understand you're not going to announce that you're running for president right now, but when do you think you might make a decision one way or the other?
Well, all I can say is I hope that somebody does challenge the president. I think that and what I've seen out there, what I experienced on Friday in New Hampshire and what I'm seeing is that there is a crying need out there for some Republicans to stand up and say, this is not normal, this is not right. We want Republicans who will take higher ground and to see what's going on right now in terms of the chaos and these actions that clearly are not conservative on tariffs and whatnot. So it's not just the policies, but the behavior as well. People want to remember the Republican Party as the decent party, and it is not right now. So what I'm seeing is there's a crying need for that. I don't know who will step up in the end. I hope somebody does. I'm not ruling it out, but I certainly have, I think it's the odds are long that I would do it.
But just to be clear, it's not necessarily because you think that this person, whether it's you or John Kasich or Ben Sasse or whomever, would be able to defeat the president. It's just a point of taking a moral and principled stand, right?
Well, certainly right now, nobody would defeat the president. But 2 years from now, we could have a completely different scenario. Nothing focuses the mind like a big election loss. And what might happen in the midterms is that big election loss. As my friend Charlie Dent in the House said, this is a five-alarm fire after what happened in Pennsylvania politically. So who knows what will happen, but it would be extremely difficult to defeat the president right now if the election were held in a Republican primary. This is the Trump party right now. I just am not sure that it will be 2 years from now.
Senator Jeff Flake, Republican of Arizona, thank you, sir. We always appreciate your time.
Thank you.